Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and welcome back to Okami. In the last one, I left off after doing a bit of... just running around doing a bit of... wrapping up a few loose ends, exploring a few things, stuff like that. Now we are out here, and I'm going to do a bit more exploring out here because I think there might be a bit more that I can do out here before I do anything else. I don't know what the deal is with this water, why it's more of a yellow color. I don't know what that's all about. Around at just about everything at night time. So let's go back to daytime and see if there's anything around, any animals around that worked out at night. It's mostly just birds that aren't out at night. I'm not sure. It really was at the pier. Orca, I mean. We didn't believe him, but Urashima was telling the truth. Oh, Urashima, the great Urashima. We were wrong and you were right all along. So yeah, now the kids are apologizing to him and treating him like royalty, pretty much. I thought there were like three or four of them. Okay. know if I mentioned, but that's only an island out there. Down to the Dragon Palace. Whirlpool picture kind of looks like a windmill or something. Why is this place called Watcher's Cape anyway? The view's nothing to write home about. Talk to this guy first. This is Watcher's Cape. Said the gods once used this place to return to the heavens. At night, this place offered a great view of the starry sky. Even the Whirlpool Galaxy was visible from the cape's tip. Whirlpool Galaxy. It's a group of stars. They form the shape of a great spiral like a heavenly whirlpool. But since the demon-shaped island appeared out at sea, there are more and more monsters about and the skies have dulled. The magnificent starry view can no longer be seen. I'm here in the hope that I'll be able to make a wish, but shooting stars are rare now, not like before. Sigh, if only a star would shoot across the night sky, then I could make a wish upon it. If you wish upon a star, it always comes true. Even the Whirlpool Galaxy might appear in the sky again. Why don't you stand next to me and help me look for shooting stars? There, a shooting star. I've got to make my wish right now. I wish that the sky was as magnificent as it was in the past, and that the Whirlpool Galaxy was visible again. There we go. I did have to talk to him first. That's it, the Whirlpool Galaxy. My wish really did come true. Now I need to go out here. Wow, check out that whirlpool of stars. It's like a huge windmill in the night sky. They say the Whirlpool Galaxy is the key to the Dragon Palace. If so, then the Whirlpool entrance should be somewhere under it. The sea looks pretty calm to me, and the Whirlpool Galaxy isn't even swirling. What do we gotta do to make that Whirlpool entrance appear? I think you're onto something. Maybe we're supposed to blow that starry whirlpool round and round. Try it again, Amy. Keep using that wind power of yours. whirlpool entrance to the Dragon Palace. The whirlpool galaxy's bringing it to the surface. Okay, I mean, it's about time we got on down to that Dragon Palace. Let's go teach those Dragonians a lesson. They're gonna pay for not keeping that water dragon on a leash. Now I need to make sure it stays nighttime, I think. I might be able to get in there during the day now. I'm not sure. But I gotta go and get Orca, and I gotta ride Orca over there, and he will bring me down into the Dragon Palace. Because number one, he's the only way you can get out there, or you can get down to it. And number two, if I tried to just get out there on my lily pads, the water dragon would eat me. Hiyo, Orca, away. Dragon Palace. Finally, Ami, we made it through that whirlpool down to the bottom of the sea. This must be the Dragon Palace in the Kingdom of the Dragonians. Their leader, Orihime, controls the water dragon. We better not let our guard down. Now we've got this origin mirror here, so we can use origin mirrors to warp down here rather than having to ride Orca down here every time. Plus, I believe there's a mermaid spring in here somewhere too. Halt, you white beast. What business do you have in the Dragon Palace? You talking to us? The Dragonian Kingdom is no place for land dwellers. State your name. Who do you think you are talking to us like that? Besides, you're the ones who let that water dragon run amok. I'm Issen, wandering artist and protector of Queen Himiko, the ruler of Cyan City. Now hurry up and go fetch your leader, Orihime, for me. Chop chop. I have no time for lowly servants. Himiko? Queen Himiko from Cyan City? Then that white beast must be... Hey, what are you two babbling on about? You gonna get Orihime or not? This way, oh beast of white. Her Royal Highness will receive you in the throne room. Don't ask me how this works underwater, but it does. And I don't know how this is underwater either. Oh my god, so many little boar piglets. attacks all of the boars now. Because I know there weren't too many of them left. I'm pretty sure I was over 50% of the way done with the boars, wasn't I? Cyclops. This curmudgeonly blue brute usually flies and smokes a pipe. If its pipe goes out, it becomes enraged and calls forth lightning. However, relighting the pipe will calm it down almost instantly. So yeah, you saw me do that when I fought that thing. And 96% of the boar piglets. Dang. I wonder if I missed some somewhere. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. I wouldn't be surprised if I did, but still. I hope I didn't, but has your journey here tired you, oh esteemed guest of Orhi? It's been decades since we had a land-dwelling visitor here, and a lupine guest at that. I must say this is quite unusual. I wish I knew what Orhime was thinking. Since when do they let dogs into the Dragon Palace? Still, I'm not one to turn my nose up at a customer, even a dog. This is the palace's treasure vault, and I'm the vault keeper. But everything's got its price, see? You wanna buy anything? I guess. Visitors are few and far between here. Presumably the guards allowed you in here then. I see, so you're no ordinary wolf, are you? No doubt you're part of some plan Orihime has devised. You better hurry to the throne room and meet with her. This place is just weird. achievement unlocked to Dragonian Dilemma. Welcome, both of you. Welcome to the Dragon Palace. You are in the kingdom of the Dragonians now. I couldn't care less who or what you are. All I'm interested in is that lady sitting on her rump over there. That's your leader, right? Well, we have some choice words for her. Yes, it is I, Orohime. I think I'm pronouncing that properly. I don't know. Ruler of the Dragon Palace and leader of the Dragonians. Leader of the Dragonians, Orohime. Okay. Anyway, we wanted to ask you something. You know that water dragon that's been running amok lately? It's under your control, right? Well, why don't you keep that thing on a leash? And what's with sending your emissary to come get us? Are you really that desperate? The Dragonians are prepared to do whatever is necessary. Amaterasu, origin of all that is good and mother to us all. What the? You know about Ami? The water dragon is our guardian deity and protector of the seas. It kept the peace by pacifying chaos wherever it reared its head. But that all changed just 1 month ago. Oni Island, the dark place of ancient legend, suddenly appeared. Evil beings swarmed into the sea and laid siege to the Dragon Palace. We mustered our forces to battle, but the enemy was too strong. Most of our realm fell into the hands of the forces of darkness. It was then that the water dragon appeared. With overwhelming strength, it routed the enemy's forces, but the enemy's leader, the Dark Lord, had unimaginable powers. The water dragon nearly fell in the face of his onslaught. So grave were his wounds that he flew into an uncontrollable rage. The dark forces then pulled back from the sea, leaving behind these chaotic waters plagued by the rampaging dragon. So you're saying that control of the water dragon? We never had control of the water dragon. It is our guardian deity. But its madness now endangers us as much as anyone else. You've got to be kidding me. The water dragon is supposed to break the barrier on Oni Island. What hope do we have of attacking the enemy if it won't help us? Indeed, there is little hope left. It appears that all has gone to the Dark Lord as the Dark Lord planned. Your Royal Highness is not through speaking yet. Yeah, I was trying to talk to her. Yes. The Water Dragon is our guardian deity and protector of the seas. It kept the peace by pacifying chaos wherever it reared its head. But that all changed just 1 month ago. Yeah, we just heard this. Just told me all of this. Tell me the other part. We cannot break the barrier on Oni Island without the water dragon. It appears that all has gone. That all gone as the Dark Lord planned. We don't need to hear all that stuff again. We can't break the barrier on Oni Island without the water dragon. Miko prayed so long and hard to locate that dang island, and now we can't even get on it. Come on, Ami, you're a god, ain't ya? Don't you have some secret weapon hidden up your sleeve? Please wait. It is true we cannot control the water dragon. However, there is still a way to harness its power. There is? Then why didn't you just say so? It is a deed of last resort and fraught with grave danger. Alas, it is beyond our power. That is why we summoned you. You probably want us to go tie a leash around the dragon, right? Well, we're not going to do anything crazy like that. It's not like we couldn't pull it off or anything. Right, Ami? I mean, Orca would probably help us out, right? This deed of last resort is as follows. We must retrieve the dragon orb. Dragon orb? What's that? So you're saying we can just forget about the water dragon and go hunt for the dragon orb thing? Sounds like a piece of cake. I mean, we're treasure hunting pros. We already know the location of the Drake Orb. It lies in the belly of the Water Drake. You must enter the Water Drake and spot. Come again? The Dragon Orb is the essence of the Water Dragon's power. With it in my possession, I could easily break through the barrier that protects Oni Island. Will you not enter the Water Dragon through its gaping jaws and retrieve the Dragon Orb that lies deep in its belly? With it, I could break the barrier that protects Oni Island. Now wait just a second, lady. Go get some orb from the Water Dragon's stomach. Are you nuts? That is the only way left to break the barrier on Oni Island. Will you not enter the Water Dragon through its gaping jaws and retrieve the dragon orb that lies deep in its belly? Yeah. Whoa, slow down there, sister. I make a habit of never saying no to a pretty face. But if my boss here says no, there ain't much I can do. Well, boss, we gonna help this chick or what? Bummer, well, the boss has spoken, huh? But Amy. Your compassion is truly as deep as the sea, and you are ever quick to decide. This amulet will allow you to enter the Water Dragon's Garden. Water Dragon's Garden. That is correct. The Water Dragon makes its lair in the garden here at our palace. Here at this palace? That thing lives here? It does, but it will not attack us as long as we leave it be. I doubt we will come out alive if we entered its lair, but I truly believe that Amy can retrieve the dragon. I shall pray for your safe return. Okay, so we have to go down inside of its belly and retrieve this dragon orb. Look at the mess we're in now. Why are you always so eager to please? Ah, forget it. Let's go get that barrier breaking orb. The Water Dragon's Garden should be around here somewhere. Okay. Yes, it's over there, but I want to go over here first if I can. Sorry, I didn't mean to do that. If I can, I would like to go over here. Oh, you've got a shell amulet, so you have the permission of over here. Forgive my rudeness, you may pass. What rudeness? Yep, this is the place I thought it was. Why are you digging this dried up spring, donkey? Hoping to smash the rock under the spring to find water, are you? You must have a good nose on you. That was my plan, too. You've got an awfully, masculine voice. Come on then, doggy. Help me dig down under the spring. We'll see if we can smash through the rock and revive the spring. Okay then, here we go. I'll tell you how we're going to dig through. Although, I guess you're pretty good at digging already, huh? Once I'm down to the deepest rock, I'll hit it as hard as I can. You just focus on digging and get me down to the deepest point. Got it, or do you want me to explain that again? I'm fine. Great, don't let me down. So another digging mini game. What? What? Oh, do I have to make my way up there? Why is that not working? What the hell? Oh, thought that's what the deal was with this one. I remember this one was more difficult, but I couldn't remember what the reason for that was. Back down the way I just dug up. I was remembering that one was tricky. I forgot that was the reason that you have to dig your way up and then back down. Yeah, right on, wahoo. I smashed right through that rock. And look at that, the spring's gushing again. Not sure that you smashed through the rock, or the spring's running again, but... achievement unlocked, digging it. This isn't good. This swirly-whirly is missing. The world's gone? Exactly. It's the swirly-whirly that's kept us all in good health up to now. Without it, we'd lose the will to live. Anyway, enough. Just whining about it's not gonna help, is it? Everyone, we've got to summon the swirly-whirly back again. We'll transfer our passion and enthusiasm into the spring by running around it as fast as we possibly can. That's a new brush technique I have, or a new brush ability I have now. I can now do that on Mermaid Springs to travel without having to... without having to use a coin, I think. followers in need and your own pure heart have restored my power. I, Nuragami, have a new power to bestow upon you. I have harnessed the fervent energy of those in need to create the power called Fountain. Use it well. Yeah, right on, Wahoo. The Swirly Whirly's return to the spring. The Swirly Whirly Spring's real name is the Swirling Spring. It's a portal to the it's a portal the Dragonians made to connect to the land. If you jump in when it's swirling, you can go to different places. Sometimes we girls use it to get out and have some fun on land. Oops, you won't tell Orihime about that, will you? Anyway, thanks for all your help, doggy. Here, have this. You'll be surprised at what's inside. I knew it. Brute strength is the only answer at the end. From now on, the Dragon Palace dance troupe's motto is muscle. Oh, well, good luck with that. Boy, Amy, that's one mean brush you do. I bet you could summon one of those travel whirlpools anytime you want if you use that technique on a mermaid spring. Now we can travel across Nippon for free. Guess it pays to help people every now and then. I was remembering it being difficult because I, for whatever reason, when I would do this, when I did this the first time, I didn't put together that I had to repair that. I kept trying over and over to do it and I couldn't get it, and I was like, why can I not make this jump? And then I was like, oh, duh, repair it. Got a shell amulet? That means Orihime must have found you worth it. Forgive my rudeness, you may pass. Again, what rudeness? Amy, doesn't it seem like we've been meeting lots of girls lately? I mean, how long has it been since we ran into a guy? I only half hope they don't take advantage of me. Oh, Jesus. What the hell's wrong with you, Isin? I mean, I know what's wrong with him. He's a total perv. Water dragon. How many times did that rampaging sea monster almost finish us off? So it makes its home here, eh? That's one huge nasty looking mouth on that thing. Think we really could go in there and come back out alive? I mean, we're not talking about the Emperor's stomach here. Well. Go. Inside the dragon. That just sounds weird. Well, here we are. This is the water dragon's stomach, huh? Is it just me or is it unbearably hot and humid in here? With the way this dragon is running amok, I'm sure we'll see all sorts of gruesome things down here. I just hope I don't lose my watch. Think we're really gonna find that dragon orb in here, Amy? probably, considering this is where it is. I must have missed the thing when I hit that before. Now I don't remember if there are any in here, but if there's a stray bead in here, I have to get it now because I can't come back. So if there are any, let's hope I find them. I don't remember if there were any in here or not, though. Because it's a dick. This part being frustrating. I don't know if it was just time consuming or what. Or that, yeah. Why didn't that work? Yeah. remember there was something particular about this place, about this part. That's what it was. Again, why did that not work? It's a thing where if you stand on it, it regenerates your life and stuff. Okay, what's the reason for that? Why is that there? There's a reason for it, right? Yep. Comment on this, isn't it? Nothing to say about this, huh? Tangled up in all this flabby stomach muscle. Looks like a glass ball or something. Digest us in a second if we fell in. I think we're gonna be sick. Look at that hunk of tissue. Looks like it's keeping a lid on that disgusting liquid. Yuck, it's all squishy squash. And what's with that bright red liquid that keeps falling from it? Would you stop messing with it for a while? You're grossing me out. I bet that fleshy mass is keeping a lid on that red liquid. We're history if that thing blows. I'm warning you, Emmy, you better stop messing with it. What the heck are you doing? That red liquid is raining down now. What'll happen if that fleshy mass dissolves? Now you got me interested too. Flooded with that icky red liquid. We came to find the dragon orb, not to end up lunch. Yeah, I don't understand how that's even possible, but disappear after a while? Do they get like... Or is that just because I'm drawing new ones? That's because I'm drawing new ones. We gotta do something about this ball that's stuck here. But thanks to you, the whole place is covered in this red liquid. We're gonna get digested alive if we keep fooling around like that. You obtained Dragon Orb. Nice work, Amy. You finally got that Dragon Orb. Finally? Now we should be able to break the barrier on Oni Island. Once Miko locates the island on her crystal ball, Danny's stronghold will be totally exposed. Yeah, but now we've got a fight, too. Boy, you sure had a hard time pulling that orb out. I wonder if the dragon's gonna be okay. Let's go, Amy. We can't get it. I mean, we got the orb. No use sticking around here. We've got to fight. What the heck? Are these the vengeful spirits of the people the dragon gobbled up? No, wait. These aren't spirits. That weird color can only mean one thing. Foxfire. Nice. I could have done better, but I didn't do too bad. You obtained fox rods. heck was that? It was kind of freaky. Looked like a bundle of bamboo twigs or something. I know, I bet those are the fox rods that Busty Babe wanted. You know, that ultimate weapon against the Dark Lord? Heck, I knew it. You should have tried to pull that orb out more gently. I'm too young to be digested. Let's get out of here. Now we have to make a mad dash for the exit, or we have to be dodging all this shit on the way out. Not that hard to dodge it. It is very possible to get by it though. Especially considering it's that room. They give you plenty of time though. I kill it. Oops. The water dragon. It's dead. Now, don't fish float to the surface when they die? I'm assuming that would be like a fish. Now what are we supposed to do? We have the dragon orb, but no water dragon for it to control. No matter how hard Miko tries to locate Oni Island, without that dragon, there's no way we can break the barrier. Hey, something's coming. I'm afraid there's no time left for me to speak now, but I do need to thank you. What for? And who are you anyway? I am King Wada. The 27th King of the Draconians. King of the Draconians? So then you were that water dragon? It was I, the water dragon, god of the sea, ruler of the deep. Oh great god Amaterasu, as you well know, there are ill omens heralding the coming of great strife throughout Nippon. Even the Dragonians have suffered under the forces of darkness. They seek to prevent me from using my power. The power to break the barrier that protects Oni Island. I waged battle against the Dark Lord and consumed the dark instrument he wielded. But the instrument lodged in my stomach and drove me to madness. Instrument of the Dark Lord? You mean this thing? Yes, the fox rods. Without the fox rods, the Dark Lord has limited power. Now all of the monsters are doing everything they can to locate them. I see. They're like a key to his power or something. I can rest easy knowing they are in your hands, Amaterasu. I also ask that you give my wife, Ohime, the dragon orb. It is the heart of the dragon. It will bring peace to my people. Alas, my end is near. I have slain many innocents while in the grip of madness. I pray that their souls may rest in peace in these watery depths. These deep blue waters the people of Ryoshin Coast so dearly love. Farewell, Amaterasu. I shall pray for your good fortune. Amaterasu made it. Busty babe. I saw the crazed water dragon thrashing about from the shore. So I hurried here to the dragon palace just in case. You don't have to worry about us. I mean, nothing can stop old Ami here. Not fire, not water, not... Tell me, Amaterasu, what happened to the water dragon? Did he reveal the secret of penetrating Oni Island? Hey, it's not nice to interrupt. I was on a roll, babe. Anyway, the water dragon was actually the Dragonian king. He turned into a dragon to protect the dragon palace. He even snatched these fox rods from their boss. You found the fox rods? Come to think of it, weren't you looking for these, babe? Aren't they the ultimate weapon against the evil beings? Hey, wait a sec. What about what you said about the fox rods? You know, about the ship sinking before they reached Himiko? Why'd we search that stupid ship if they weren't really there? If you're still upset that I put you in danger, I'm sorry. But time is of the essence now. Give me the fox rods quickly. Now you just hold your melons, babe. I mean, if those monsters are frantically searching for them, whoever has them will have a huge bullseye on their back. I hope you know what you're doing for your big furball. It's an eerie light they give out, yet somehow alluring. With this, my holy powers will reach their limit. I can destroy every last demon there is. Protecting Queen Himiko with this great power, that is my duty. Don't worry, Amaterasu. I must hurry back to the city now. I shall honor my duty with my life. With your life? Don't go getting yourself killed, babe. Ah, she's gone. Hey, Em. Quit spacing out. We gotta deliver that dragon orb we got from the water dragon to Orihime right away. We probably can't count on the power of the water dragon anymore, but the Dragonians still consider the dragon orb as their treasure. We better return it to them. There's a big old fish skeleton there. So how did she even get down here? I'm back, baby. Oh, what a relief to see that you are unharmed. And what of the dragon orb? You retrieved the dragon orb from the dragon body? I have no words to express my gratitude. Now that I have the dragon orb, I can harness the power of the water dragon and break the barrier around Oni Island. About that water dragon, it sunk to the bottom of the sea when we took that orb thing. Does that mean the king of the Dragonians is... I mean, is that King of the Dragonians really your... Yes, it is true. The Water Dragon was King Wada, my husband. He performed the ancient Dragonian rite of transformation in order to battle the forces of darkness. But he was gravely wounded and flew into an uncontrollable rage. If the king is dead, then the law of succession must be fulfilled. The dragon orb had to be recovered, whatever the cost. And alas, the cost was the king's life. Hear me, Issen, as I have said before. The Dragonians have the resolve to do whatever is necessary. We mustn't hesitate. Now then, Amaterasu, what of the dark instrument of the Dark Lord? Surely you found it lodged in the water dragon's belly. Oh, you mean the fox rods? Queen Himiko's attendant took it. She said something about using its power against the evil beings. Himiko's attendant? It is true, the dark instrument has unfathomable power. But evil beings are doing all in their power to find it, too. I truly hope this attendant you speak of is trustworthy. All hope would be lost if it fell back into evil hands. Yikes, what's up with this thing? A revelation, perhaps. Perhaps King Wada wishes us to see something before he departs. Do you have any idea what that vision meant? Come on, Annie. Where are you going, Amaterasu? No time to explain now, babe. We gotta get over to Ankoku Temple quick. Remember, Amaterasu, there is still hope. I shall wait here for Queen Himiko's revelation. Let us meet once again wherever Oni Island may appear. May the god of sea watch over me. Pick up heading to Ankoku Temple in the next episode. So that's it for this one. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And as always, I will see you in the next episode.